The latest 18.1 beta just dropped, and we just got two huge features. You can now try the cleanup feature in the Photos app, which lets you tap, brush, or circle subjects, and your iPhone will remove them from the photo. And if you have Apple Intelligence, not only will you get summaries and text messages and emails, but you can actually get summaries from any app on your phone. Reminder, this is the 18.1 Dev Beta 3. It's the latest one, and these features will come out later this year once 18.1 is available for everyone. First, let's check out the new cleanup feature in Photos. I'll go to a photo here where there are some subjects in the background that I might want to remove. Now when I tap the settings icon here at the bottom, you'll see a new icon in the bottom right called Cleanup. The first time you tap it, it actually has to download the cleanup feature. That might be some on-device learning or LLM. But once it's downloaded, you can then go into the cleanup mode and it'll actually start recognizing subjects you might want to remove. Zoom in on a subject and you can see it's highlighted here. I can just tap it and that subject will be removed from the frame. And it's using a bit of photo AI to try and replace what was behind that subject. Pinch and zoom to other places in the photo, and it will even recognize multiple subjects. And if you want to remove them all at once, you can then circle all of those subjects, and Apple Photos will do its best to remove them and replace it and generate content behind them. Here's one more subject. We'll circle that. And now all the subjects have been removed from this photo. No one is left. Now, even when you hit done and save this photo, and now the photo is saved without the subjects, if you go back into the editing, you can still revert back to having all those subjects visible in the frame. So if I revert to original, all those subjects come back. Now this does work really well when there's just one or two subjects in the background. Here's a photo of my family in New York City. I'll go into the cleanup mode. And if I zoom in, you'll see there was someone kind of behind us right there. Cleanup is already highlighting it, so I'll just tap that subject and they'll disappear from the photo. Even this person's head kind of behind my son's shoulder, tap that and they're gone. Save this, and now you have a clean photo without people in the background. Keep in mind, this does just work for photos. There's no cleanup option when you go into edit a video. Now, if you're looking at a photo with multiple subjects, this cleanup feature is gonna struggle a little bit to replace what's behind them. So here's a big group photo we had. I'm gonna go into the cleanup feature, and it doesn't really highlight anyone right away because there's just too many faces. Now, if I zoom in, I can actually just brushstroke someone. So I'll do this on the subject, and you can see it's not that great at actually removing and replacing that subject. I can keep doing the brush icon. Maybe I'll just try to circle this whole subject here. There, it did a little better job removing it, but you can see a little strangeness happening behind where that subject was. Again, there's just not enough data for it to actually replace it. Let's try a face back here. If I circle it, and cleanup did a pretty good job removing his face, but you still have some artifacts down here. So your mileage may vary depending on how many people are in the photo. And I found when there's a lot of small people in the photo, here's a picture from the Oculus Mall in New York City. I'll go over to the cleanup feature and it'll actually start highlighting people. You see all these different highlights. I'll just circle them all right here and let's see what cleanup removes. It's gonna work to remove a lot of those people, but it doesn't remove everyone. Now, if I zoom in, I can try to remove some more just by circling and let's see if that does it. It recognized some more subjects, removed them, and you can also brush. So I'll just brush up and down, left and right on the different subjects, and it'll attempt to remove as many of them as possible. It's actually doing a pretty good job replacing it with plain floor. And if I do enough of this, maybe I can actually get a pristine photo with no one there. As you can see, the more and more I remove, it gets a little rough trying to replace it with the photo. So this is likely not gonna work in large crowds of people, but for individuals just in the background, it does a pretty good job. Now this also works with photos you would have saved to your phone. Doesn't have to be one you've taken with your camera specifically. So here's an image I've saved from the web and you can see it still highlights people in the background. I can just tap the person, tap the other person, and they're gone from the photo. Let's try one more group shot. This is actually an older photo I took back from 2011. I'll go into the cleanup feature and that's me right there. Let's try to tap a subject and see if cleanup can recognize it. I may have to brush it instead. Will it remove them? Maybe not. Let's try removing both of them. Oh, and there it did try to remove it, but something horrible has happened. Again, this is the first time we're seeing this feature in a beta, so yeah, sometimes you might get that. Now, another major feature in 18.1 are Apple Intelligence summaries across all your apps. You can actually enable this by going to the settings, and this doesn't live in the Apple Intelligence settings. This is actually in the notification settings. From here, you can go to Summarize Previews, and then you can actually enable it for all the apps you have on your phone. I enabled it everywhere. You actually see this splash screen when you first upgrade to 18.1 and you can enable it right there with one tap. And here I actually sent myself a text using Google Voice. which wasn't summarizing previously. You only got mail and text messages. But here, I actually get a summary from the Google Voice application when someone texted that number. And you should see these summaries in apps like Slack, Microsoft Teams, and anywhere Apple Intelligence can summarize it. Now, unfortunately, I did look in the shortcuts, and I did not see new actions for these features. So you don't get cleanup photos as a shortcuts action. And unfortunately, there's still no Apple Intelligence or summary actions for shortcuts. And lastly, one other quick feature that I haven't covered yet. This is in all the iOS 18 betas. But if you do use the stock Apple Podcasts app and you listen to a show with chapters like Primary Technology, highly recommend you listen. That's my tech podcast with Jason Aten. Now, when you go to the Now Playing screen, if you scrub back and forth on this playhead, you'll actually see the chapter markers designated by these lines. And there's even a little haptic feedback as you cross some of these thresholds of the chapters. So a nice visual representation of chapters here when you're scrubbing with your finger. That's directly in the Apple Podcasts app. So those are the two big new features in iOS 18.1. Again, this was the developer beta 3. 18.1 is probably going to come even later than when we see the iPhone 16 launch, which, by the way, that event was already announced. Apple said September 9th is the announcement. They're going to be announcing likely iPhone 16 and maybe even a new iPad mini. So subscribe to the channel right here because I'm going to recap that event. And we're also going to do a recap episode on the Primary Technology podcast. Links to subscribe to that is down in the description. But if you want to see all the other Apple Intelligence features like writing tools, summaries, and more, check out my video right up here where I go through all those features, including what they look like in macOS Sequoia. And if you want to see some of the big features coming to iPadOS 18, I just released a video on that literally this morning, and you can check that video out right up here. Again, don't forget to subscribe, hit that like button, and thank you for watching. We'll catch you next time.